Good day, everyone. Role of I'll be talking about my study, role of MDCT in evaluation of vasculopathies causing CNS disorders in pediatric and young adult patients. Introduction: in children and young adults, most of the stroke is due to cardiomyopathic stroke and arthritis diseases, which is a bit less than in the other older age group. In this presentation, we'll talk only about the aneurysmal lesions and non-arthritis diseases causing stroke. Intracranial aneurysm account for around 10-15% of hemorrhagic strokes, whereas non-arthritis diseases are account for about 10-15% in adult and 20-25% in pediatric patients. Non-arthritis vessel diseases can present as a mild headache to the stroke or ICH, and it may be difficult to diagnose without imaging. And imaging also provides some lead to the clinician regarding further evaluation, like targeted biopsy or any biomarkers like CSF aspiration, etc. ACH due to aneurysmal rupture can be diagnosed and treated clinically, but use of CTA helps in diagnosing and treating it to prevent further episodes, otherwise which will lead to further morbidity and severe mortality rate. Aims and objectives: to assess the use of MDCT in diagnosing vessel disorders, to establish the effectiveness of MDCT as initial imaging tool for the intracranial and extracranial vessels, to determine the spectrum of radiological characteristics of different etiologies, which leads to stroke whenever possible. Materials and methods: the study was done in Usmani General Hospital in patients presenting with symptoms of stroke. By this, 26 patients were included in this study who are showing intracranial and extracranial vessel disorders. The CT's study was done in 128 slice scanner. Initially, non-contrast CT was followed by CT angiography. CT angiography was done with a collimation of 0.625 mm. For this, a 60 ml contrast was used, which is injected at rate of 3 to 4 ml per second and followed by 30 ml saline flush. The observations were characterized based on the vessel, part of vessel involved, extent of involvement, territory of parenchyma. In case of aneurysm, narrowing down the location based on the based on the location of ACH, then size, position, and relation of the aneurysmal vessel which is needed for the intervention. And also, in case of AVM, the study was also correlated with the DSA to identify the feeding artery, draining veins, and the nidus wherever possible. Inclusion criteria: patients with the CNS symptoms of stroke. Exclusion criteria includes traumatic patients, intracranial SUV patients, and patients with chronic renal failure. Results of my study: of the 26 patients, 12 were in the pediatric age group, and the rest 14 patients in the young adults. Most of the lesions were seen in between the third to fourth decade. Levy fistula and malformation cases were further correlated with the DSA to correctly identify the vessel and arteries, and feed draining veins and nidal aneurysm sizes. And in case of vasculitis group, high resolution MRI was not opted for the patients because of multiple episodes in the past. In the pediatric age group, four cases of moya and three cases of Takayasu arteritis was presented, and one case from each of AV fistula, which is a pyLAB fistula, one case of focal cerebral arteriopathy, primary CNS angiitis, sickle cell disease with multiple basal collaterals, and one from tibial vasculitis. In the young adults age group, four were showing AV malformation, four of aneurysm, which is mostly in the fourth and fifth decade. Two cases of spinal dural AV fistula, which is seen after 40 years. Two cases of connective tissue disorder vasculitis, which is seen less than 40 years of age. And two cases of tibial vasculitis. Discussion: a study by Ahmed Abdel et al. On topic of imaging spectrum of CNS vasculitis. CT angiography can be used to evaluate both the vessel walls and lumen. And it also showed vessel wall abnormalities when there is no luminal abnormalities, which is correlated with the conventional catheter angiography. And it also demonstrates there is any presence of aneurysm, thickening, and also accurate assessment of stenotic lesions in large vessels. A study by Tarasov et al. In Moya disease showed CT is sufficient for ischemic or hemorrhagic stroke. And particularly, it is helpful in identifying occlusion or stenosis in large intracranial vessels. A study by Eric et al. In ABM patients showed CTA, if timed properly, can depict a nidus, feeding arteries, and draining veins. And it is 90% sensitive in detection of AVMs compared to MRA, which was time of flight MRA, which was only 74% sensitive. A study by Mahesh V. et al. On intracranial aneurysm in a by MDCT for a intracranial aneurysm, it showed a sensitivity and specificity of above 90%, and it also helps in identifying multiple small aneurysms in patients with non-traumatic SAH. Few cases. This is a case of Moyamoya disease, where you can see bilateral IC narrowing, and there are multiple thalamus perforating and pale collaterals. In this patient with presented with SAH, there is a aneurysm arising from the right internal carotid artery. And in this another patient, there is another saccular aneurysm arising from the internal carotid artery. And this patient, we can see a small tiny aneurysm arising from the right posterior inferior cerebellar artery. This is a 10-year-old girl presented with a weakness. As you can see, there is a thickening and narrowing of left common carotid artery. It's a case of Takayasu arteritis. In this case of AVM, in a 40-year-old female, as you can see, the surface shaded display showing AV malformation with a large intranodal aneurysm. And this male, 45-year-old male, there's a right parietal occipital AVM, but predominantly presenting as ICH. These are my references. Thank you.